All right, thank you very much. Good evening, parents, and welcome to the Grade 6 graduation for 2022. This year, we're so fortunate to be able to hold an in-person graduation with parents in attendance, which we're very lucky. We'll begin the evening by welcoming our Grade 6 classes of 2022. So, can you please join me in welcoming 6A?
Thank you.
6 Day, and our final Year 6 class for 2022. Please welcome 6 E. What an entrance from all of our Year 6 classes. Please join me in giving one last round of applause. Now to officially begin our graduation ceremony this evening, please welcome our school captains for 2022, Ashley Videsha and Patrick Robertson.
To our 2022 Year 6 graduation ceremony. My name is Ashi, and we are your school captains. I will now read aloud the acknowledgement of country. We acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which you stand today and recognize the continuing connection to land, waters, and culture. We pay our respect to the elders past, present, and emerging. This year, we have been very fortunate to not have had lockdowns and have been at school the whole year. It has been very rewarding to have done lots of fun things such as the beach program, cross country, inter-school sports, rock climbing, and wherever we can. We would now like to wish the students and teachers a wonderful graduation ceremony.
Thank you very much. Ashi and Patrick. And to join them in opening our graduation ceremony this evening, I'd like to welcome our school principal, Greg Lacey, to the stage.
Thank you and good evening and welcome everybody to our graduation ceremony. It's so good to have parents back here. It's so wonderful. Give yourselves a round of applause. For those who don't know, I don't have a great desire for Kit Kats, but I do love them. This is an islander tradition. Sometimes they but thank you to Malachi and the family. So I've worn these a couple of times during the ceremony. It's always an honour for me to do that. Can I welcome you to what will be a fantastic evening? I know the kids have been very nervous today. We've been busy signing beers and footballs and all sorts of things today. They're a little bit nervous, a little bit excited. I'm sure it's going to be a great evening. No rain, isn't that great? And it's not 45 degrees, because it's what it normally is at this stage of the year. We're normally sweating ourselves almost dead on a graduation evening at this time of the year, but it's a perfect evening this morning, so fantastic. Year 6, thank you for your entrance. You look fantastic this evening. Really pleased with the way you presented yourself. I know you're going to be very proud to come up here and receive your certificates and awards. I'm very proud to be part of your graduation this evening. Thank you again to the parents and enjoy every moment of this. Take it in. Thanks everybody. So one of the traditions we've had since the very first graduation back in 2011 when the school first opened. Well, it actually happened in the second one because we couldn't do it in the first one, could we? The tradition has been that the Marriott Shield Award winner from the previous year comes back to talk a little bit about their experience in Year 7 to the graduating class, and talk to them and give them some advice about what they might expect next year as they transition into Year 7. So I'm very pleased to welcome Mathuki to the stage. So Mathuki was our 2021 award winner who had to receive her award without appearance here on video. So I'll leave you over to Mathuki. Thank you, Mathuki.
Today, I'm here to give a little introduction to how life at secondary school is and to deal with any possible concerns that you may have. One major problem that most of you may think that you will experience is how your first day will turn out. I admit, I was a little nervous on my first day too. Transitioning from primary school to secondary school may be a little daunting at first. However, you will always have your new teachers and friends there for support. You are also provided with plenty of time to adjust to your new school life. You'll be fine. Another thing that most of you may be worried about is making new friends. It may seem difficult at first, but don't worry. Making friends at high school is very easy. You will have plenty of opportunities to make new friends at different school activities, such as camp and different school excursions, and still keep in contact with your primary school friends, even if they go to different schools. I, myself, have made plenty of new friends at my school, as well as still continuing to hang out with my primary school friends. And I'm always up for a chat with those from Lentis Primary School. A common question asked by Year 6s is how difficult the workload might be. I attend Cranbrook West Secondary College, and most of the work I get is work I couldn't finish during class, and some questions to advise what I have learnt. Homework usually is different from school to school. Some of you might get a fair bit, while others will barely get any. Overall, the homework standards are pretty similar. It may be confusing to get used to a new routine with a lot more homework. However, you'll be fine with all the experience you've had from Lentis Primary School. The timetable setting and opportunities provided throughout Year 6 will certainly help you to adjust to a new school life. My advice for you all is to keep calm and enjoy your new school life. Also, remember to try new things and to never give up. I would like to wish everyone a successful first year of high school. Thank you and good luck.
Thank you very much, Mathuki. It really is a wonderful tradition to have our returning Mary Ritchie Award winner from the previous year come and share some reflections on the transition into secondary school and how Lentis Primary School has prepared you to make that move. So we will now be presenting our Grade 6 classes with their graduation certificates. After presenting each class, teachers will also announce the recipient of our Encouragement Awards and School Values Awards. Students chosen for these awards have shown outstanding effort both in and outside of the classroom and have consistently displayed the Lentis Primary School values of optimism, respect, integrity, responsibility and empathy. Thank you to the ACE Foundation for their support of the Encouragement Award and Damien Cullinane Painting for supporting the School Values Awards. Can I please ask 6A to come up and line up at the side of the stage, and Ms. Bell, if you could please come to the stage to present your class.
To acknowledge Mrs. Lord, the teacher for 6A, the first two terms. So as the new 6A teacher from term 3, I was afforded the opportunity to spend the remainder of the year learning alongside my students in a room full of laughter and engaging conversations. 6A jokingly refer to themselves as the noisiest classroom in the school, yet as a group of students, they showed me the utmost respect and displayed resilience when faced with such a big change. I want to thank each and every one of you for our time together, and I hope when you look back on grade 6, your memories will be as fond as mine. I wish you all the best for high school next year and the world beyond. Congratulations, 6A. I will now present your graduation certificates. So, Aidan. Member of 6A, who always displayed the school values and completed work to the best of their ability. I encourage them to reflect on their achievements this year. Even after missing a lot of learning time, they have shown that hard work will take them far. I hope that in receiving this award, they feel encouraged to grow in confidence, showing everyone their kindness, resilience, and desire to be a proud, upstanding student of Lyndhurst Primary School. Congratulations, Edward. Goes to a student who has consistently shown the school values of respect, responsibility, integrity, optimism, and empathy. Every day I have been blown away by their unwavering respect for their peers, their teachers, and most importantly, themselves. As a responsible school leader, their values of integrity, optimism, and empathy were evident when supporting students in their role as house captain, but also within class when persevering in challenging tasks. Congratulations, Chanel.
Please join me again in congratulating 6A. Well done, 6A. Can I please now ask for 6B to make their way to the stage? And I'd love to invite Ms. Kitch to join me on the stage.
Congratulations also on behalf of Senior American, who took the grade early on in the year, and Mr. Flanagan over here as well. I'm glad that I've had the pleasure of teaching grade 6B. You are intelligent, flexible, and full of zest. Together we have challenged ourselves and grown as learners and people. 6B, each and every one of you has a unique character. I'm confident that you will use your strengths and kind heart to make your mark in high school. It is with our pleasure that we award the 2022 graduates of 6B.
Stage. Zaria. Lana. Krish. Ryder. Aaliyah. Levi. Amelia. Absent this evening, but part of our graduating class in 6B, we have Sachi. The next to join us on the stage, Lachlan. Nazir. Isabella. Michael. Bassi. Kashan. Alara. Roy. Savannah. Also part of our graduating class but absent this evening, we had Viraj. And next up joining us, Devanj. Ruben. Samara. And Abby.
Now for the Encouragement Award. So this student works productively and is creative in everything they do. They show amazing ability across all areas of their learning. Their company is enjoyed by their friends. They have grown in confidence to participate in group work and have delivered some fun presentations. I encourage this person to persist through challenges, and I know they will get through anything in life. Nazir. And now for 6B's School Values Award. By accepting their own strengths and weaknesses, this person has been able to respect others. By harnessing a growth mindset, they have gained the ability to make good things happen. They have quietly but assuredly gone about completing tasks and know that good results come from their own effort. They have a strong moral compass and are kind and empathetic towards others. Amelia.
It really was a pleasure teaching 6B this year, and I know that Miss Kinch and Senior American would agree with me. Please join me in congratulating 6B. Our next graduating class this evening is 6C. 6C, if you can please make your way up to the stage. And Mr. Jarvie, you can come up to the stage to present 6C with the graduation certificates.
First of all, I'd like to thank my Class 6E. It's been an absolute pleasure working with you all, culminating in this moment where you're ready to progress to your next new exciting phase in life. Each and every one of you has shown positive characteristics that are a credit to you all. It's been a year of many fun, exciting and happy memories, full of growth and development that I hope you hold dearly with you forever. I've enjoyed the enthusiasm, the banter, the teamwork, the growth, and also the challenges, but most importantly, getting to know each and every one of you. You should all be proud of the individual journey you've faced throughout the year and how you've risen and adapted to become the individuals you are today. I've no doubt that with continued hard work and effort that you'll achieve the successes you are looking for. I'll stay tuned for some big and bright updates in future years. I'll now present the graduating certificates for 6C. Ashy. Kieran. Keisha. Keisha. Max. Jacob. Jermaine. Jay. Friday. Foster. Jack. Alina. Summer. Ryan R. Anand. Selena. Alexander. Karan. Priya. Paris. And Tiana. I'd also like to acknowledge a student who couldn't be present here today, and that's Avni. Now, I'll also announce 6C's Encouragement Award. The student receiving the Encouragement Award for 6C in 2022 demonstrated an honest and thoughtful approach to their own learning. They showed a motivated and self-driven attitude and a level of commitment to their own learning of which they should be incredibly proud of. They were very dependable in all aspects of the classroom and could be relied on to participate in the school community, and your contribution was strongly valued. The recipient of 6C's Encouragement Award is Ryan R. The School Values Award for 6C goes to someone who epitomised the Lyndhurst spirit by demonstrating our school values. This person presented with an optimistic attitude and was always one of the first to give challenges a go. Not to mention the way they presented themselves in an empathetic and considerate manner. On top of this, the respect they gave to their peers and teachers around them was first class and thoroughly represent the key values we stand for at Lyndhurst Primary School. The recipient of 6C's School Values Award goes to Paris. Have a final round of applause. Congratulations.
6C really were a lovely class, and it was a pleasure working next door to you guys this year. As 6C make their way back to their seats, I might just ask our students that have received their graduation certificates and pens, we can just pop them under our chairs. They're quite tricky, and they seem to just fly out of hands without much notice. Can I now invite 6D to please make their way to the stage, and Mr. Bacon.
It's been a pleasure to teach 6D this year. It's been a brilliant year with the students being able to participate in excursions and camps again. It's been filled with excitement, laughter, and perseverance. As a collective, they have developed skills in working with others, resilience, and setting personal goals. I wish them all a safe and wonderful summer and a smooth transition into year 7. I will now present them with their certificates. Andre. Sandra. Sarah. Maddie. Rajni. Mia. Holly. Hensel. Simarat. And Melander. Mayha. Rhea. Beyonce. CJ. Corey. Subtest. Austria. Anaya. Yuraj. Alara. Owen. Tiara. On to the 6D Encouragement Award. The students started the year and they were a bit shy, so they didn't really participate much in class discussions and in circle time. They would always just pass. But as the year progressed, so did their confidence. Throughout the year, he has continued to set realistic learning goals and has really worked on developing stronger social skills with his peers. Then we got to camp, and he flourished. He pushed himself both physically and mentally, especially on the zip line. So, congratulations, Ashvir. Was it worth it, Ashvir? On to the Student Values Award. This is probably a difficult one to pick because in all honesty, I've probably never worked with such a polite and well-mannered class. But this student is always well-mannered, polite to both teachers and other students. So always got good reports from CRTs that were in on the day saying how polite this person is. They take pride in their learning, and they're an outstanding role model for others. Just always shows respect to the school community. And when you give her feedback, she'll always act on it. She'll be an outstanding asset to her new school next year. Congratulations, Maddie. We can just give another round of applause.
We now come to our final graduating class for 2022. So can I please ask 6E to make their way to the stage. And Mrs. Squires,
okay, it has been an absolute pleasure teaching 6E. Some of their highlights this year have been the Colour Run, Warrabinda Camp, and the Big Day Out, just to name a few. I've enjoyed your good sense of humour and admired your confidence. You have expressed an eagerness to learn and used your strengths and energy to persevere. I've known most of you guys since prep and was lucky enough to teach some of you in grade 3. And I've absolutely loved watching you all grow and become the young people that you are today. I would now like to welcome the graduates of 6E for 2022. Can Sahail please come to the stage? And Amelia. Cooper. Francis. Afrin. And Morales. Oscar. Dion. Mia. Garange. Taylor. Mark. Tazeen. Sophia. Dina. Hi, Dina. Mackenzie. Arav. Isabella. Simona. Ezekiel. Isaiah. Leo. And lucky last, Ojess. My encouragement award goes to someone who has continued to grow in confidence and persevere through the expectations of Year 6. They always challenge themselves academically and socially, and it has been wonderful watching them focus on their goals and self-discipline to accomplish them. They are respectful to their peers and teachers and show empathy towards others' feelings. I have loved watching you take the time to help those people around you. I encourage you to continue to be yourself and challenge yourself to do great things. Congratulations, Afra. My Values Award goes to someone who is kind, caring and polite, not only to their friends, but towards everyone. They continue to achieve great things without asking praise and always strive to do their best. It has been wonderful watching them flourish this year in gaining confidence and achieving their academic and personal goals. This person works well with all of their peers, and they have been passionate about fulfilling their leadership roles. Each day, they lighten up our classroom with their infectious smile and positive attitude. Continue to aim high and dream big. Congratulations, Dina.
And one more great big round of applause for 6E. Nice to see you way back to your seats. Very fortunate to have had the opportunity to teach a lot of our Year 6 students over the years in my role, my former role as a PE teacher in British Primary School. So I've seen a lot of them grow from prep and moving their way through into Year 6 and as a Year 5 teacher last year. So it really has been a pleasure, and they are a wonderful bunch of students. So if you'd all please join me in giving them a great big round of applause. We now come to the part of the evening where we recognise some of our students for their outstanding individual achievements. Awards are given to students who have excelled in different curriculum areas. Our subject awards are supported by Area Specialist Karan Singh, and I would like to invite Mr. Javi to the stage to present the Numeracy Award.
The Numeracy Award at Lyndhurst Primary School encompasses one's ability to consistently demonstrate competency in three key mathematical areas, as well as being proficient at posing questions, thinking critically, and applying problem-solving strategies. The student receiving the Numeracy Award for 2022 has demonstrated a high level of application in all aspects. They have been a high achiever within the classroom and have participated in higher order thinking programs such as ICAS and Maths Olympiad. Leaving no stone unturned, they worked diligently and responsibly to improve their mathematical knowledge and demonstrated higher order skills that have proven that they are definitely on the road to success. The recipient of the 2022 Numeracy Award is Shannon.
Next up, we have our Literacy Award for 2022, which will be presented by Miss Bell.
One by one, we were loaded off the beast that held us captive. We suddenly halted, and there was visible confusion. Couldn't see, but it seemed we had run into something or someone. If I told you we said excuse me and moved right along, I would be a dirty liar. That was a narrative excerpt from the recipient of the Literacy Academic Award. These lines show that the student is working at a level of literacy beyond their years and deservedly should be recognised for their achievement. I wish to congratulate and encourage the student to continue to display their exemplary writing ability. Congratulations, Harvia.
Congratulations, Harvia. Which will be presented by Mrs. Squires.
The Inquiry Award goes to someone who is very creative, has an inquisitive mind, and enjoys challenging themselves. This student has been an active participant during our inquiry discussions and brought knowledgeable insight on the topics that we have covered this year. Their learning has flourished when exploring their interests through our learning intentions. I have thoroughly enjoyed your good sense of humour, ability to make others smile, and our insightful conversations. Congratulations, Isaiah.
Well done, Isaiah. And congratulations to our three, classroom-based award winners, subject award winners. I would now like to welcome some of our specialist teachers to the stage to present our specialist subjects award for this evening. First up, we have Mr. Hamilton, who will be presenting the Physical Education Award.
On behalf of Mrs. Hunter, who can't make it tonight, we have come up with a deserving winner for the PE Award. This person in class just displayed great teamwork, sportsmanship, respect for their teammates and their teachers, represented the school at a division level in swimming, cross-country and athletics. They represented the school in school sports in basketball and netball, and on top of that, often ran lunchtime training sessions to assist those that were not as familiar with the sport to try and improve their skills. They also organised and ran various lunchtime clubs and competitions for students across the school, presented sports reports at assemblies, and did a magnificent job as one of our sports captains this year. So our winner for our PE award is Isabella Sprouse.
Congratulations, Isabella. Our next specialist award will be the music award, which will be presented by the other Mr. Flanagan.
Thank you, Mr. Flanagan. Well done, grade sixes. Special night for me also. The first school I've been to, I've been able to see students go all the way from prep to grade six, so it's been fantastic. All right, the music award goes to a person who I've taught on and off for the past 7 years. This student loves music and has a natural singing ability. This student was involved in the Victorian State School Spectacular, senior choir, and sang in the ukulele orchestra. She has performed at assemblies and the summer concert and will be performing tomorrow night at Hampton Park Christmas carols. This student brings a happy and positive vibe to music and helps keep our music classes enjoyable. I am proud to announce that this year's music award goes to CJ Perkins. Congratulations, CJ.
Next up, we have our Performing Arts Award, which will be presented by Mr. Sketcher.
Thank you, Mr. Flanagan. I'm going to do things a bit differently. I'm actually going to announce the recipient of this award straight away. So the Performing Arts Award goes to Taylor Marshall. Taylor is very deserving of this award. She's a polite, she has a positive attitude. She's a polite and mature nature. She's hardworking. And she's very responsible. Taylor has also been a dependable as a music captain and has been a fine role model. Taylor enjoys performing music, has made a fine contribution to her music programs, including the ukulele orchestra, senior choir, and the State School Spectacular. Congratulations to Taylor. Can we give her a round of applause?
Next up, we have our Art Award, which will be presented by Mr. Gleason.
All right, the recipient of this year's Art Award consistently produced artwork of a very high standard and was able to do this using a variety of tools and materials. This person is very design-orientated and was able to use planning time effectively to apply her creative flair. This person's work could be described as simplistic, yet striking and skillfully executed with lots of care taken. When drawing something from observation, this person has a very good eye for proportion and shape. It's with great pleasure that I announce the recipient of this year's Art Award is Sarah Beltran. Our science teacher, Mr. Klimsch, unfortunately was disappointed he couldn't make it tonight, so he's asked myself to present it on his behalf. He's written a few words which I'll read to you now. This student would often ask thoughtful questions and give considered responses. They demonstrated an excellent commitment to studying science. They consistently applied themselves to complete all science tasks and displayed some excellent critical and creative thinking, showing me that they have a promising future in science. Congratulations, Bowen Town.
Congratulations, Sarah and Bowen. Next up, we have our Digital Technologies Award, which will be presented by Mr. McKechnie.
So when you select a leader, you can go for a guaranteed applicant who's sure to fulfil everything their role description entails. They have all the skills and knowledge to make things happen, but the lingering question always is, how can they grow? How can they challenge themselves to find out that they could always go further than they thought possible? I had no question for the person getting this award that they would get a lot out of the role. This person dedicated themselves to all areas that were required. The person demonstrated a wealth of knowledge when it came to ICT, digital technologies, and made sure skills were passed on to peers. He should be proud of himself, along with his family, and I think you all should be proud of him too. Congratulations, Savtez from 6D.
We now have our Spanish award, and we're very fortunate to have our Year 6 teacher and Spanish teacher for many years, Senior America, presenting this award.
Buenas noches. I have the pleasure of presenting this award for Señorita Adonis, who has taken over the Spanish program this year on my behalf while I was off being a mum, arguably a harder job. I have had the pleasure of teaching a lot of these students for over 6 years, Spanish is prep, and I'm still in awe that you guys are here in grade six. So big. This award for Spanish goes to a student who has made such a positive impact in and around the Spanish classroom. This student has promoted and supported the use of Spanish around school through our event days, lunchtime clubs and assemblies. She has been an amazing student and advocate for Spanish this year. Thank you for an amazing year. That was written by Señorita Adonis for Mejaco.
Final specialist subject award for tonight is the Wellbeing Award, which will be presented by Mrs. Smith.
I know it's been said a couple of times tonight, but I will reiterate, it has been so nice getting back to seeing each other in real life again and learning and actually socialising face to face. But this has also brought its challenges this year, and it has been exhausting for all of us, and for some, very scary getting back into the swing of things. This year's Wellbeing Award recipient has been very helpful in getting people back at school and making them feel welcome. So she, I've given her away. She is an extremely empathic young lady, I can say now, who supports and encourages their peers. They consistently take steps to check on and improve the well-being of others. They deal with challenges and resolve problems in a mature way by expressing their feelings, whilst always also having the understanding of the feelings, rights and beliefs of others. The recipient of the 2022 Wellbeing Award is Tiana V.
Congratulations.
Congratulations to all of our specialist subject award winners for this evening. We now come to a point in the evening where we celebrate a select group of students with three very special awards. So the first of these awards is our Community Spirit Award, which will be presented by Miss McCann.
I'm very honoured to be presenting an award tonight. This award sits somewhat separate from the rest of the awards tonight in that it's provided by one of our local members of Parliament, Sonia Kilkenny, based on the nominations from the teachers at the school. Engagement within our school community. She takes part in every opportunity available and has represented our school at a number of major events. She is a role model for her peers and demonstrates excellent leadership skills. This student has provided support to her teachers in and outside the classroom. I would like to congratulate the recipient of the Community Spirit Award for 2022 to Isabella Squire.
Each year, the Lyndhurst Scholarship Award is awarded to a student who has demonstrated the school values in all aspects of their learning and interactions. The recipient of this award in 2022 is a student who has consistently displayed the school values all the way through and through grade 6. Their smile brightens up the room, and their flair and creativity shine through everything that they do. This student has shown passion in the various school roles they have undertaken. They are a great role model to others, and have demonstrated diligence in their work through monitoring their learning and managing their commitments. Your teachers have loved the way you share your viewpoints with others and your passion for fashion. It is with great pride that I announce our 2022 Lyndhurst Scholarship Award recipient. Congratulations, Zaria Anderson.
We now come to our final award for this evening, the Murray Shield Award. And I would like to invite Mr. Lacey to come to the stage to present this award, which is sponsored by Harvey.
Thank you. Just before I call up the winner of the recipient of the award, I just want to give you a little bit of background for those who don't know. This whole area was a farm, and it was the Marriott family who owned that farm. They used to have a house still down on Thompson's Road. They moved back out to the country now, but this was quite a big cattle property. And for the first few years of the school, they were great supporters of our school and helped us get started with lots of things that happened around the school and sponsored us and came to events. So it's pretty special in terms of the history of the school, this award. And connected with the very first year that the school was opened and the history before the school was here as well. So I'm going to do what I usually do in this one. I'm going to call up the person who's won the Merit Shield for this year. He's actually our Student of the Year Award. There's a perpetual trophy that goes with it, which now becomes a beautiful piece of history in our school, recording all of the Students of the Year since the school opened. And this year's recipient is Cooper Bradridge. Yeah! Stand there and get embarrassed. As you can see, a fairly popular choice. Cooper has been a house captain this year and he takes his leadership skills and responsibilities very, very seriously.
but he's just a joyous young lad to have around the place. Extremely polite and courteous, committed to his studies. He takes great feedback from his teachers, always trying to do that little bit better, and accepts that feedback and applies it to his work. That's the kind of person that wins the Merit Shield Award. The Merit Shield winner is the person who demonstrates those values, including the one that's missing up there. Which one is it? Integrity, well done. But he does show all of those values, including integrity. And that's the Merit Shield Award that we choose every year. Not only is he fantastic with his studies, not only has he been a great leader around the school, not only has he been a great social person to have around the school as well, you know what, he's just a ripping young bloke. And I wish him well.
Don't forget this one, Cooper. The certificate that goes along with the shield. Unfortunately, you can't take the shield. Maybe. You can't take the shield. Can we have one last big round of applause for all of our amazing So you can probably tell that our Year 6 students are getting very excited because none of them have seen this before, except maybe our ICT. So, each year we're very lucky to have our wonderful ICT teachers create a special video presentation for our graduating class. So, here's Mr. McEachran to present this year's Year 6 graduation video.
So when we were coming up with this graduation video, we put out a Google form to all the students to find out exactly what they wanted to do. We thought of a little short narrative, it's something they might want to do, but they all really wanted to do a song and have some dance along to it. And we had a Dan Job, our Satez, editing, filming a lot of it. But most of the groups you see up here, they've all come up with it by themselves. So it's a true testament of student agency and really getting teachers to step back and the students just really doing it the way they want to do it. So enjoy the video.
Thank you, Ms. McEachran, and big congratulations to the students that were a big part of producing that video, and well done everyone for your spectacular performances. So, next up, we have something quite special. So I'd like to invite our Year 6 students to the stage for our Grade 6. So, our Year 6 students will be performing the song Que Sera by Justice Group. Thank you.
one that's been a long day. Has enough, giving up, we don't okay. We don't care what the world says. We spread love, it's the only way. So you gotta be strong. Live by the words of the song. Together is where we belong. Never stop dreaming.
Keep holding on.
From our Year 6 students. A lot of work went into this, so one more great big round of applause. We might try our battle again, so on three. One, two, three. Welcome, Year 6s. You can make your way back to your seats.
Goes into planning graduation. It starts probably about term three when we start to think about getting the halls moving for graduation. We'd like to thank the office staff for all their administration support. Thanks again to the sponsors, ACE Foundation, Area Specialists, Karan Singh, Damien Cullinay Painting, and Highview Accounting. Thank you to all the teachers who have assisted in many ways. Thanks to Jono for organizing our photo booth, and to Svetlana, who provided all the balloons and decorations. And Mr. Flanagan, Mr. Sketcher, Mr. Thomas and Mr. McEachran for organizing the sound and providing technical support. To the PFA for their organization of the food for tonight and for the disco later. We ready for the disco? Okay. I'm not sure Mr. Bacon is ready. Also, thanks to Mr. Flanagan for emceeing for us tonight. And lastly, thank you to the families of our grade 6 students for joining us and for your continued support throughout the year. Thank you.
And just one more thank you, a big thank you to Mr. Bacon, our Year 6 team leader this year. It's been an absolute pleasure working with you, and thank you for everything you've done for us throughout the year and for the students. Next up, I would like to invite our school captains, Ashi and Patrick, back to the stage for a special presentation.
On behalf of all the students, we would like to thank all the staff for helping us through our primary school years. We are very grateful for your hard work and determination. We would like to present Mr. Lacey with a book signed by all the grade 6s of 2022. Thank you, Mr. Lacey, for creating this wonderful school for us and for us to flourish into the great young people we are. Lastly, we would like to wish all the students good luck transitioning to high school.
So the book is another tradition. It's a Guinness Book of World Records, and we have one of those for each year the school's been open. The school captains have handed those over too. So I'm just going to close this evening with a bit of a speech, see if we can get through it. It's just so wonderful to have everyone back here together, sharing this face-to-face, so we're really pleased about that. It's the first time we've had parents at our graduation since 2019. It's unbelievable, isn't it? So this is a celebration tonight, but not just one of successfully completing 7 years of primary school, although that's worth celebrating on its own. It's also a celebration of the resilience, mental toughness, and the strength and character of the students who sit before us. Their last 3 years of primary school have been interrupted and completely upended by a once-in-a-century pandemic. That includes 22, a year that we thought would be getting back to normal. 22 is far from normal, but we still suffer the impact of COVID in so many ways. And yet, here we are with this amazing group of young people who have so much to celebrate and reflect upon. I want to take the opportunity to talk to you all about celebration, that word, celebration. It's common form, it just means let's party, but celebration can take place in so many ways. Celebration can be a quiet personal reflection on what you've achieved and what you are proud of. Earlier in the year I spoke to you about this being a no regrets year. It's a talk I give to all the grade sixes at the start of the year. I stoked no regrets in that I gave you the challenge to sit here tonight and reflect on things like: did I take on every challenge with my best? Did I try new things? Did I try difficult things? Did I take every opportunity given to me to challenge myself and grow? I think you have. Listening to the radio today, I actually had a different speech written. I heard this stuff on the radio this morning, so I thought I had to put it in. It was fantastic. Listening to the radio today, I heard a soldier talk about the head in the pillow celebration. Apparently it's quite common among soldiers in the army. His nightly routine was to lay his head on his pillow and reflect on the day, thinking about the things he was proud of, the things he could quietly celebrate. Maybe tonight when you lay your head on your pillow, you could do the same thing. Think about your year, Were you the sort of person that made yourself and others proud? What are you most proud of? You've all been challenged for the last 3 years by some very difficult times, and here you are at the other end, graduating. You can all be proud of that. I'm proud of you, and so are your parents. It's been tough. When you meet a challenge, it's an opportunity to learn and grow. Whether you beat the challenge or fail, you still have an opportunity to learn. I wonder what you've learned about school and about yourself through these COVID years. Recently, I was fortunate to hear from students globally who've been asked what they had learned from the pandemic, what they thought education should be like in the future, what key messages they had for us in schools. And we're listening. We're very much about student voice here, and we are listening. What these students said was they need space to learn and to heal. They need different pathways because they all learn differently and have different needs. They need to feel hopeful for the future. They need education to be delivered in different ways through different digital platforms to support their learning. They also said don't underestimate the impact students have on other students, a really important message. They wanted to make building relationships with students a priority. They want us to value students' thinking and skills and provide space and time for skill development because learning is more than succeeding academically. They said that students cannot thrive without basic human skills, financial skills, communication skills, emotional intelligence, and values like integrity. Students want school leaders to listen and act on what they hear, and we're listening. Students want educators to talk to them about their needs and wants, and I know your teachers have done that for you. Learning should happen inside and outside the classroom was also something they said. How am I going? I think some good points here. They also said students wanted leadership opportunities so they can develop knowledge as they serve their community by applying their learning in authentic contexts. I think again, we've hit the mark there. I hope we've been able to provide these opportunities during your time here at Lyndhurst. I hope when you lay your head on the pillow tonight, you can reflect on the opportunities you've had and say, I have no regrets. I tried my best. I took some chances. I challenged myself. I gave it my all. If not, then there's a challenge for next year. Best of luck to you all. I know your teachers have prepared you for the challenges that lie ahead. We are all proud of you. Continue to make us proud. Can you stand, please? Turn to your parents. Can I present to you the graduating class of 2022 from Lyndhurst Primary School? Thanks, guys. Take your seats.
Thank you very much, Mr. Lacey, and once again, congratulations to all of our Year 6 students who are graduating this year. Just before we move on from our graduation ceremony, there's just a couple of little housekeeping things. We will be having a disco later on, not too far away, which the students are obviously very excited about. So we will have a period in between of about half an hour for parents to mingle with students, take photos. We have a photo board at the back with some of the memories from Year 6 in 2022. And we have a photo booth set up by our IT department for students to take some photos. For parents, if you are choosing to depart and you are going to take your child with you prior to the disco, that is fine. But if you could please just check in with your child's teacher so that we can tick them off to make sure that everyone is making it home safe, that would be really appreciated. And for parents that will be returning to pick their child up at 9 p.m, at the conclusion of the disco, if you could do the same, and just see your child's teacher so that we can make sure that they're getting signed out and heading home safely, that would be really appreciated as well. And I think that is it for this evening. So, we hope you've had a really enjoyable graduation with us this evening, and Students, hope you have a really great night and enjoy your final day at Women's Public School tomorrow. Thank you.